Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Codgers Wrap-Up Show. Here we're on the campus of Fairland High School. I'm joined to my left tonight, kind of a different arrangement, by the Codgers, Mr. Coach Dave Carroll and Coach Jack Harris. We'll send it over to those guys.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our year-end show. I'm Jack Harris, the older Codger, and I'm joined with my cohort in partner in crime, Mr. Dave Carroll.
Coach, what do you think about this set we're sitting
on
here?
Oh, I feel like I'm in the ESPN studio.
Well, I think we are. Jerry Bell and the kids work. I posted some pictures on Facebook today and showed them all them setting everything up in this room. Had students in the background. It was pretty nice. But if you guys look at your left and your right, you can see the Codgers, and you can see our banner down below. That's pretty awesome. What do you think? Pretty good?
I think my wife probably is thinking that, our banner picture, uh-huh. She probably thinks those eyebrows are better than what I have on right now.
All right. Well, I guess let's start out. Let's talk about a recap of the basketball season. Can we do that? We got some clips for you guys at home. And the first clip we're going to show you is a clip with Coach Speed from the post-game show after the win at Ironton. So take it away.
This morning about 7:30 about how big this game was going to be, and congratulations, all your guys played well.
Yeah, I thought we played really hard consistently the whole night, and that's what we focused on. And we played much better, more physical defensively. At times we hit some lapses where we didn't box out. We had a good defensive possession, and then we just gave up the rebound,
Right.
And we got to definitely finish, do a better job of boxing out. But offensively, when we play quick, we play well and get good shots. I think when we slow down and overcomplicate and overthink things, then, our offense gets really stagnant. But, I thought these two did a great job tonight of controlling tempo, controlling the game, moving the ball, keeping the ball moving, playing great defense. They both had tough assignments tonight, and they just both had a fantastic game.
They did, but Coach and I were talking. There's two other guys that we noticed tonight. Bryson Hunt.
Hunt was up.
Yeah.
And Peyton,
animal on
and
board.
Peyton Jackson came in and abs. Most people at home not paying attention.
Right.
But we're up here watching. I'm seeing that little bit of push in there.
Yeah.
And that, that little physicality. You needed that tonight.
Well, yeah. If you need physicality, put Peyton in. That's for sure.
Well, I thought Bryson Hunt was all over the floor, too.
I thought Bryson, in a sense, he's been done such a great job of offensive rebounding the last few games. I think it's been the last, three or four, where he's just getting a lot of offensive rebounds, keeping possessions alive, or putbacks, and just playing with that energy. And that extra possessions helped us so much. He's doing that well. And, it's taking him a while to get comfortable. And I think right now he's hitting a stretch where he just gets better and better and more comfortable with the ball. His decision-making is good. Defense is good. He's, like I said, his best attribute, he's just offensive rebounding so greatly.
Tell you another fellow I thought had a great game for you guys was Will Davis.
Yeah, Will played really well.
Will, he's very good at taking the ball. He doesn't shoot very many jumpers.
Yeah.
He used to.
Yeah.
Seemed like he did last year. This year he seems to be
driving
a lot and he's been the receiver of a lot of great passes from this fellow right here.
Absolutely.
Hey, that one behind that little bounce pass behind your back was beautiful tonight. Hey, that's about like Kylie Bruce. She had a couple last night that were fantastic, but Chase, that one behind the back was nice tonight.
Will has played a lot better. I think he's being more consistent, and I think at times he needs to look to shoot more.
Right.
He shoots it well, and he's playing really well and definitely locked in.
Well, Friday night, South Point.
Yeah.
I told this young man right here that was probably the greatest defensive effort I've seen out of a team and out of an individual on this court.
Yeah, thank you.
You look to do that again.
Yeah. They'll definitely be ready.
They're going to be out for revenge. And
tough place to play.
And you guys are staying in first place now with tonight with four teams tied at the top.
Yeah.
But now one of them's gone, and Dragons are still there.
Yeah.
Who did South Point play tonight, and who did Chesapeake play tonight? We don't know.
I don't know. I think
I'd
South.
I'd say it about had to be conference game.
Yeah, right? It'd have to be
now.
Like Colgrove,
Rock
point.
Hill, Portsmouth.
Yeah, we have to play Portsmouth twice still. Ironton and South Point have to play, two times two.
Oh,
so,
really?
Yeah. So, yeah, it's still going to
be some battles.
Be down to the last few games.
All right.
Well, we did say we thought that the conference champion could have two losses. Hey, Coach, we could have three.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, honestly,
yeah,
I mean.
No, there's no question. I mean, it's just a meat grinder in the OVC right now. I mean,
well, we were talking about that,
yeah.
too, how competitive
yeah.
and how good the conference
yeah.
is this year.
Yeah.
So I got a question about Friday night. Coach Harris and I are going to come down. We're going to watch the game. But,
yeah.
you know, you had a great game plan to take Lovely out of his game last mm-hmm. time. Really did a good job. What kind of changes do you think Coach Wise is going to make this time? Because he knows probably about, unless you've got something, which we're not going to talk, unless you've got something different. But he's going to have to make some kind of changes
yeah.
to try to get him more into the offense.
Yeah, you know, he's a tough guard one-on-one. I mean, I haven't seen too many teams that can guard him, you know, straight up for an entire game. I mean, you've got to do what you can to keep the ball out of his hands, limit his touches, you know, get him extended from the basket as far out as you can. You know, I'm sure they've said and worked on those things from the last game, and, you know, we're going to have to come with some counter defense and things like that and be more aware of those situations.
Coach Harris, you got anything else?
I'll tell you what, it's I think you hit the nail on the head when you said the faster you guys play, the better you play.
Mm-hmm.
Because that game and this game, you guys played really fast.
Yeah.
And I've noticed that over the past, too,
mm-hmm.
that the faster you guys play, the better you play.
Yeah.
And
yeah, I think we've
I'm
talked
talking
about
that before. Defensively and offensively.
Yeah.
And
we get in a situation sometimes where we're, you know, defensively, we're not at that point yet where we're almost too timid. We're playing not to lose, you know, and we've just got to keep taking good shots, but we got to keep attacking and stay, you know, defensively
sure.
focused.
Well, I'll tell you, that was a physical game tonight.
Yes.
And that first half, I thought the difference was that neither team came out and shot the ball extremely well
no.
at all.
Yeah.
I think, what was it, 13-9 in the first quarter?
I
something
think
like
so.
That.
It's slow. And, really felt kind of slow.
You guys were the first team and the best team that found yourself.
Yeah.
And you kind of carried that in through the next three quarters and
yeah.
and was able to pull off the victory, but it was a hard-fought one.
Coach,
oh, gosh.
I think when Terry went out in that second quarter, that was kind of changed the game a little bit.
Oh,
right
definitely,
there.
For sure. Yeah, I mean, I would agree. It you know, changed the complexion of the game, and I think that was about the point where we just kind of started to settle in. Like you said, I think it was a slow start, and I think both teams felt that, you know, intensity and pressure to start the game, and it's, you know, coming down the stretch, it's who's going to be able to get over that quick enough and execute. You know, and make plays, and you know, I think, like I said, both teams felt that tonight to start.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Looking forward to Friday night. Told these guys to practice hard, stay healthy.
Yeah, yeah.
And hydrate, because
yeah.
they're going to be
a
lot of energy come
well,
Friday
I'll tell
night.
You, Friday night, that's going to be an awesome atmosphere down there.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It always is. Always is.
Yeah.
Travis is very – Coach Wise is very animated also, so
– I haven't noticed. Never seen that side of him.
Oh, well. Well, Coach, I guess we ought to wrap this up tonight.
Okay.
We'll be back Monday night.
Monday night in another barn burner.
And then we'll be back Tuesday night for you guys.
Yeah.
Chesapeake, that'll be a big game.
Oh, yeah, right. Definitely.
So,
man, that's awesome. It's fun to be back up here, Coach, I can tell you
I'm
that.
Enjoying it.
Yes.
It's been good. I enjoy watching these guys. I mean,
yeah. These guys are amazing. I'm telling you, they do things. I'm like, gosh, how did he do that? How did he see that guy? How did he see that guy? And Brody's knocking down those threes, and it's like I told him earlier. You know, Sean Terry just toasted him on the football field, but not inside yeah. this gym. That quickness, only thing we get you so far
yeah.
until somebody helps out.
Yeah,
but. Brody did an excellent job.
He did.
Thank you.
All right, Coach, I guess we're going to sign off here.
All right, Coach, we're back. To tell everybody at home, that was our longest clip we're going to have. But just kind of give me your thoughts. You get to watch that again.
That was our first game.
That was our first that
boys
was our
game.
Boys game, yeah.
Yeah. Well, that was a dandy. I think getting Sean Terry in foul trouble was huge, but Brody played huge. Will Davis, I like to talk about. Bryson Hunt, just all over the place, rebounding.
And what people at home have to realize is when we went down to Ironton, they thumped us pretty good down there. They did what they wanted to us.
Right. You know, I think that's probably the reason that you play home and home in basketball. It's too bad you don't get to do it in football. And sometimes it's probably good that you don't get to do it in football.
It probably is.
But I also want to talk about Chase Allen. He had a tremendous season. And you just don't leave that boy open.
No. Brody there, that was also the other one. He played a heck of a game that night,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, both those guys I thought were very, very good at attacking the basket. Not only do they just shoot threes, but both of them can take it to the rack and they can finish. And sometimes you're going, my goodness, how'd they do that?
Well, you and I can't really get out of them stools we're sitting in, so the stuff they did is pretty amazing.
Yes.
Anyway, all right, well, let's go to our next clip. Our next clip is with Coach Buchanan, and this is a clip of the post-game show after the win over Portsmouth. So here we go.
Get this Easter jacket.
By the way,
get that jacket, buddy. Huh?
Congratulations, brother. Proud of you. Four in a row. That's awesome.
Yep. First time ever.
Way to go, brother.
That's what the girls said. I didn't realize that.
We had won three, lost one. Three, lost one. So, first time ever.
Well, let's keep it rolling. Let's get five next year.
That's right.
Yeah, it'd be tough. It'd be tough because they got everybody back.
Yeah, I know.
We can't hear Horsey Harry over there.
Yeah, they got up in us pretty good.
Oh, yeah. That's what they do.
But I didn't think the foul situation got evened out until the fourth quarter.
I'll say this. I don't think the referees felt like we could block their shot. They did not. Because every time, like, everybody felt like we blocked a shot, it was a foul. So maybe it was a foul, but, like, they did not think we could block their shot.
Well, I've been watching Kiki Woods get up in people and put both hands on them and impede their progress to the basket for 3 years now. And they finally called it.
Twice.
A little bit.
The board says twice. But two of our best players were. We won.
Yeah, hit some big free throws there in the fourth quarter to extend the lead. And what about that leap girl coming off the bench, ice cold?
I'll tell you what, honestly, when she looked at me in the huddle when she's going, she's like, I think she had an old.
Did she have the deer in the headlights look?
Oh, yeah, like she, you could tell that she was like, but honestly, when she went in, she did great.
I mean, absolutely.
She did a great job. But when we first, like, kind of like, she knew when Gabby fouled out, she kind of looked, here and I made eye contact, like, yep. It's me, and then we immediately to a timeout, and she was kind of like, but she did amazing. She did really
hey, coach,
she was definitely ready to play.
Coach, I'm proud of this one right here tonight because I want the leadership role right here that she took tonight, directing traffic. Getting
that's what I was
going to
say. Issa normally is the one, like, just being directed. Issa was the director tonight.
Yeah, that's what
she
100%
was. 100%. And, I mean, I don't, like, you love to see it as a coach, the biggest game, and then, like, you step up in the biggest game, and Issa was amazing.
I also thought
amazing.
She played some daggone good defense.
Absolutely.
Tonight.
I mean, everything. I mean
Issa,
like, just
they're
did
always
amazing.
Telling you to talk on defense. Just tell them you were talking on defense.
And she did.
You
she
did
amazing.
Y'all did a great job. Everybody just.
Yeah.
I'm so happy.
It was everything
for all
it
you guys.
Was hyped up to be, brother.
Oh, yeah. It was.
Even
that's what
that
I told
little
the girls.
Post you made last
I
night,
I
had to say.
I think everybody
that.
Got their money's worth.
Yes.
Hey, have you seen a crowd like this ever for
ever,
a girls' game?
Ever. Never, ever. Never anywhere.
You need to go home and watch a replay.
Yeah, never anywhere.
I told you know, Chesapeake plays Fairland tomorrow night, and we're doing that game, but I don't think
there
the
won't
crowd
be that
is,
many people here.
No.
No way. No way there will be that many people here.
You're absolutely right.
So, which is great, like, for our girls and their girls. You know what I mean? Like,
exactly.
Well, hey, you know what? They brought a great,
absolutely.
great crowd.
Absolutely.
And very well behaved.
They're
going to
go far in Division III.
I can tell you that, like, when we first started playing and they were bad, literally, they had the bus driver and a parent were the only two people in their crowd. They had two people.
Well, you knocked them off.
Now look where they're
19 times in a row, Coach, before they were able to get you.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, I was sitting there saying something, kind of looking in the future, but wouldn't that be awesome to make the state tournament and have two
OVC
Ohio
teams?
OVC
absolutely.
Teams?
Absolutely.
Would that not be awesome?
I know the only one I really care about, though. This one right here.
That's right.
This one right here.
But so. I'm going to root for those guys.
Yeah. Like, especially they're not in our same division.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah.
You're going to root for them.
Well, thank you, guys.
Well, your first one is
appreciate it.
against the winner of Gallia Academy.
At Ironton against Gallia and Miami Trace.
Right, right.
Week,
I don't know who sent that out, but we appreciate it. I've already shared it.
Yep.
And
appreciate it.
Coach, go enjoy yourself.
Congratulations.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, Coach, we're back. Tell us about that. Give us a little info on that clip.
Well, I thought your prediction of having two teams from the OVC at the state Final Four was spot on, brother. I mean, they lost a tough one, 47-40, and Dragons lost a heartbreaker, 53-52. But I don't know where you're going to find in the state of Ohio two teams out of the same conference at the Final Four state tournament.
And, you got to think there's only 16 teams in the state tournament altogether with the divisions.
Right.
The OVC had two.
Yes. That's
Division three and Division
that's
two.
Amazing. And don't be surprised if Portsmouth doesn't make it back there again next year. Of course, we don't know how the divisions are going to stack up yet because they're going from four divisions to seven next year. And we don't know if we're going to be in the same division with them or maybe they'll be lower down at five and we'll be at four or five and six. We just don't know yet. But
well, let's talk
about
them
for both teams to have very good.
They got everybody coming back.
Yes.
So yes, they do. Good. Tell the folks, that was a huge one of the, I think that's probably the biggest girls game we've ever had.
I think
the crowd was outstanding.
Around 1,600 people. When you count, you know, of course, you don't go by ticket sales there because everybody that was wearing green from the high school, the junior high, the elementary, were allowed to get in free. And there was, the place was packed. And
you got to
like
think the mezzanines up behind us were full.
And they brought a tremendous crowd. Like you said, everybody was pretty well behaved. And that's a testament to both schools.
Exactly.
And their communities.
That was an awesome atmosphere, though, wasn't it? For a girls' game.
I don't know that we'll do one that big anymore. We might next year.
Well, you and I have really had some good times doing these games and just really enjoyed them. And we hope you folks at home have, too. Anyway, we got our next clip we want to talk about is a clip of Tara Sanson. She made an appearance before the ball game during one of our streams to advertise the blood drive we have here at school. So we're going to watch that one right now.
Great.
Elijah Kiff.
We have a guest here. Miss Tara Sanson. Get in here. Get in here.
Yeah,
folks at home, if you can take a tune in here, switch it over. I'm going to show you Miss Sanson. She is the one running our blood drive here.
Yes, yes.
I guess we're not going to switch the camera over.
We need your blood.
Yeah. Well, let's get it. I want them to see your picture. So
I know
who.
Let them just see me.
There we go. Okay. Yes, that's it.
There it is. We need your blood.
We got 30 openings. Is that correct?
We have 30 openings. And okay. We need the double blood, the power blood givers. So
okay.
Any of the guys that can give double blood would be greatly appreciated.
All right. We're going to stop real quick, do the national anthem. Miss Sanson, we love you, and I hate it that you're leaving.
Well, she looks too young to be retired.
Well, you know, you all people at home don't realize everything that Miss Sanson does around here. I mean, we're talking about homecoming games. She does a blood drive. I mean, there's just so many things that she does for the school, for the community, for these kids. And it's hard for me to see her retire. You know, it really is because she does mean so much.
Somebody's going to have to step up.
Well, you know what? Not only is she a great teacher, I mean, my kids all had her, but she's an even greater person.
Yeah.
And she gives to these kids. And I know, you know, you don't know her as close as I do, but just a wonderful person. And Tara, we want to wish you luck in everything you do, you know, out of here. Enjoy your retirement as much as you can.
Yes.
Coach, you get how many days of golf is it a week now?
Well, I wish. I haven't golfed a whole lot this year, but retirement is six Saturdays and one Sunday. That's all I can say. That's a good thing.
I wouldn't know. All right, everybody. Our next clip we've got here is of Bree Allen, Kylie Bruce, after their win over Unioto at Southeastern High School. And, guys, this is one of my favorite clips, and we'll talk about that after it's over.
Let the short guy in the middle. Now, everybody at home, you all know what this is, right? Your girls already know, correct? This is a rose between two thorns.
Oh,
yeah. Bree, Bree, tell me about this. This is three in a row in your district championship.
Yeah, it is. We were just coming out. We were ready. I mean, they just weren't ready for us. It's pretty much the only way to sum it up.
Kylie, I thought you played in. I saw you get hit out there. Looks like you got a nice little.
Yeah, I'll probably get stitches after this. But, yeah. But I think our defense really won the game. Like, we were able to hit shots, which is, like, really big. But, really, our defense was what won it. Don't do it, get a close-up of my lip.
I told Coach Buchanan I was really impressed with your shell defense. You guys rotated really well. And, you know, you didn't leave a lot of people open. Y'all were to the ball. Y'all were on the floor. Hey, where'd y'all learn that?
Shout out to the boys' practice team.
What, Bruce?
Maybe our eighth grade middle school coach. I don't know. I think his name was Carol or something. He ran us to death.
Like I don't. That. Do you know that guy?
Oh, above the head, maybe.
Yeah. You don't know anybody that would run with the ball over top of their head, would they? For not going hard? Well, girls, listen. You all know that I love you so much, and I'm so proud of both of you. You know, you guys just had a great senior year, and we want to continue that.
Yeah.
Anything else?
All
we'll
the way.
Get some more people in here. You all going to be there bright and early.
Oh, Coach, that was one of the highlight clips for me because those two girls mean so much to me. I love them both. And, you know, they're both going to go play college basketball, and they're going to be playing against each other. So I'm hoping maybe next year I get a chance to go up and watch them kind of butt heads. But Bree and Kylie, I appreciate you guys. You know, I showed them a little montage of pictures today of some stuff. Hopefully we'll get to show here later. But those girls are super. You want to talk about them just a little bit?
I thought, you know, I was thinking about that today. What am I going to say about this one? What am I going to say about that one? Collectively, you know, when I watched them play, it was the final of the district against Unioto, and then the two games at Zanesville. And all I could think of was the most collective effort on defense that I've ever seen. When you think they limited, I think it was Unioto to 22 points. The next team they played was West Muskingum, 27 points. And then Sheridan in the finals of the regional, 31 points. And they hadn't scored less than 40 all year. So those three games right there just summarized the defensive effort of these kids. Each one of them had their moments offensively. You know, you take Issa Talaferro, for example, at Boyd County, a very good basketball team. She comes off the bench and plays out of this world. She had 14 points, hit four threes. You and I were able to witness that.
She was the difference in that game.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Just each one of them, you know, Bailey Russell, she's leading scorer on the team. Cam Barnett's knocking down threes from NBA range. And then Bree, and Kylie Bruce had the greatest season growth from her junior year to her senior year. And she just had an outstanding season. Godby, if I had one bit of advice for her, I would say work on your three, because she likes to put it on the floor and beat you one-on-one, and she did that a lot this year. And she's a good ball handler, good passer, but I think she turned down some threes this year. But
she was unselfish, Coach.
Right. She's
very unselfish.
But I think she's got to learn to be a little more selfish next year.
I'll tell you, one of the things that I loved about that clip is those two girls right there were two of the shyest girls. 3 years ago, they would have never done what they did in that interview. Both of those girls let loose. The personalities came out, really grown and matured. You know. And just like, you know, Kylie didn't even want to look at the camera. She wanted to get out there. You know, Bree just kind of hamming it up. And I really enjoyed it with them. And like I said, I talk to them almost every day. I sit down with them at the lunch table and just talk to them and just have fellowship with them. It's good.
They're very enjoyable kids.
They are. Really enjoyed them. All right. Our next clip is of Phil Porter discussing some of the new rules and regulations for high school basketball before the Lady Dragons played against the Lady Memphis Falcons. Now, Phil, I believe, was our conference assigner for officials, right. I believe. And so he did a little bit of talk about that. So, guys, we can run that clip for everybody right there. You all can enjoy Phil.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Dragon Network. We're here for pregame show. Tonight's girls matchup between Fairland and the mighty Memphis Falcons. Who was the guy from WSAZ?
Bob Bowen.
Bob Bowen, nicknamed in the mighty Memphis Falcons back years ago.
Yep.
I can remember him calling them that. And it kind of stuck, and that's kind of what they've affectionately been known as. And I know their new AD, Kristen Ruby, down there, she talks about the mighty Memphis Falcons. Before we get talking about that, we're joined Mr. Dave Carroll right here beside me. Coach Jack Harris.
I'm the old Codger.
He's the old Codger. Coach Carroll's the old Codger. Coach Harris is the older Codger. And then over on the other side, he's not necessarily a Codger, but a Southeast official, Southeast Ohio official, does some officiating in the state of West Virginia also. Phil does football, basketball, and baseball, softball still?
Just baseball.
Yeah. Phil's been doing some assigning for the OVC the last few years. We've got to know him, as one of our officials. He comes in here, a great guy. Phil, talk to us a little bit about if somebody's watching this show tonight, what would they need to do? What was the first steps to become an official, whether it's football, basketball, baseball, softball, whatever? What's some of the first steps they need to do?
Great question. The way to get into officiating now is search the web, mm-hmm. right? OHSAA.org, I believe it is, and start how to be an official. There's a link on there. It's really really basic and small. It tells you it's not really complicated. Just get in there, put your name. They'll send you information. You log in. Now to become an official, most of it's online. You get to take care of, I think, the online class about 10 hours, mm-hmm. and then you're done, and then you go to your local association, and those guys plug you in on some court training and some signal training and all that kind of stuff, and they really start you really at the basic level to build you up and see what level you can do.
And it's, I know when I did it several years ago, it's 4 meetings a year, correct? You got to attend 4 chapter meetings where
yep.
you guys kind of go over some scenarios, go over some rules, some different things that each of you maybe have seen throughout the last couple weeks, and just kind of become better officials by networking and talking. Is that still correctly
said? Yeah, that's absolutely correct. One of those the meeting points is going over points of emphasis over the year of the National Federation, new rules, or adjusting the new rules, how they have to apply to the game, and that's a great place to go to is the 4 local meetings. You also had to do 1 online state meeting for Ohio mm-hmm. as well.
You know, as you talked about it, new rules. One of the new rules this year is the free throw, foul count kind of deal. How do you think, it used to be 7 fouls per half, you went to 1-1.
Correct.
On the 10th foul, you went to 2 shots, and that was per half. This year with the change, it's 5 fouls per quarter, and once you get to the 15th foul, you start shooting 2. How has that affected the game for you as officials, and also how do you think it's affected for teams?
Well, I think when they applied the rule this year, it's been in college for a number of years on the women's mm-hmm. side, it's absolutely changed the flow of the game, the tempo of the game. It gets it going, mm-hmm. so the kids are more judicious, coaches are more judicious with it. It gets the flow back into the second and the fourth quarters, the two important parts of the game. I love the change. I know at first I had some animosity and some angst to it. I'm like, see how it applies. And it's done nothing but elevate and get the flow of the game a lot easier.
I agree. I have the opportunity. I watch all the boys' games, all the girls' games. And it's definitely changed the game as far as the length of the game has really been shortened up a little bit because the flow is a lot quicker. Like you said, we're not spending the entire second quarter or fourth quarter just shooting free throws.
Yeah, correct. The one main reason why it wasn't just the flow of the game they changed the rule is the safety rule.
Mm-hmm.
So when you shoot the 1-1, there's more kids getting hurt in between the 1-1 shots going for rebounds. So taking that away, you only have 1 chance versus 2 chances to get hurt between mm-hmm. the 1-1 fouls.
Yeah, I did read that.
That's a good point.
So I think it's been good. I know a lot of coaches were apprehensive when they started, like, how's this going to work out? A lot of fans were kind of apprehensive. I heard a lot of rumblings, this is going to, different things. And now we're halfway through the season, and the fans seem to be enjoying this change a little bit. So even though we were apprehensive at the beginning,
yep.
now it's been a good thing.
Absolutely.
As we focus here, we turn the focus over a little bit. I know you've been able to watch a lot of basketball in the tri-state area. You know, I'm not asking you who do you think the best team or anything is like that, Phil. I'm not asking you that. But just in general, from a basketball standpoint, the enjoyment of going out and watching games and not watching, but officiating, working games in the tri-state area, what's that mean to you?
Well, I will tell you, being a part of the OVC for the last 15 years, I absolutely enjoy doing majority of the teams, meaning is I love going to all the sites. Mm-hmm. Great fans, great coaches, great programs, and the kids are pushing and getting better each year, and the officials are being pushed to be able to get that next level officiating, always trying to better themselves. The teams I love to do is all, every year seems to be the local teams, unless I have to travel. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yes, I agree.
If I don't, I
agree.
Like last night, I got home at 1:30 in the morning. Mm-hmm. So if I could be home closer around 9 o'clock, 9:30, that's where I want to be.
Now, I know in Ohio you have the opportunity kind of as the assigner, and I know you get assigned games, you kind of stay here within probably 50 to 80-mile radius. Do you have that same ability in West Virginia assigners, or is it kind of all over the state?
So everybody is like an independent contractor. We get to accept games or decline games on the what we choose we want to do. So most of the assigners that I have that have the ability to assign me are local Charleston area. Mm-hmm. I do go to Logan. I do go to Chapmanville. I love going to those schools. Looks like I go to Fairland, Chesapeake, and Portsmouth, and Gallia. I love all the schools in the area to do those games.
You know, as kind of a last question for you, and we'll get into some Fairland basketball and some different things. Do you tend to normally work with the same crew every night, or are you kind of different crews? And how does working with the same crew help and working with different crews kind of hinder you?
Well, that's a great question, because it's a dual-edged sword, right? Working with the same guys, you know their temperament, you know the way they call, they know the way they're doing through there. You work with a different crew, you have to be crisp because you don't know what they're thinking. So you're working with a new guy every day. I kind of like the crew aspect because I know what my partners are thinking about, how they call. We have the same tempo. I know what they're wanting to get out of the game, and we know each other how we work. I love it both ways, but it really keeps you on your game when you're really working with new guys throughout the area. West Virginia doesn't do crews. Ohio does crews, and it works better that way.
I agree. Phil, I appreciate you. I know you guys had the second game of the day today. It was an outstanding game for not only for the teams but for the officials. You guys did a great job. I appreciate you coming up. You kind of stuck around all day helping some of the younger officials, pointing out some things and helping them along the way, and sticking around helping us out. Again, we appreciate it. You're more than welcome to stay on, chime in with us, or if you want to kind of cut out and go back and watch some more basketball, it's completely up to you. We appreciate you coming on.
Hey, thank you for the honor, guys. You guys have a great night.
Thank
God bless.
See you, Phil.
All right, Coach. Thoughts on Phil and all the information he gave us.
He's a good official. I mean, I watched him do a lot of games, and he's top-notch. And I don't think I've ever seen a coach really complain about him. You know, you?
First year I came back, Coach Middle School Girls, very first game, he had a brand-new official. The guy had never called a game ever. Well, the guy didn't have a great game. But I don't say much. You know that. Well, I got up and said something. He looked at me and he went, boop. Sit down. Not going to hear it. I reminded him of that after that broadcast.
I think he was protecting that young man.
I think he was too. But anyway, what did you think about those changes? What did you think about the after five fouls in the quarter? Did you like that? I kind of liked it.
I like it. It's a lot along the lines of the college game. The only thing that the college ladies have over the high school ladies is being able to call timeout and advance the ball to half court. But the rest of it's all the same. And I don't know sooner or later if the guys are going to go to that. I have not any idea. But they would have to. Now, I think the high school boys do, but college boys do not, because they play 20-minute halves.
Right.
We played in a tournament this past weekend, and they played 16-minute running clock, and we had to go 7 and 10.
Right.
Because it was just a half. Now, if they split up the men to 4 10-minute quarters, then you'll probably see a change.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I agree with what he said in there. He said it changes the flow of the second and the fourth quarter, and he's exactly right, because it really does.
And he also made a good point about the safety. I didn't realize that much until I just heard his commentary there. about there were a lot of injuries on that first foul shot of a 1-1, and you have really two chances to get hurt, whereas if you're shooting two shots, you only have one chance to get hurt. So that was a very good point, and I didn't realize that till just a few seconds ago.
Well, we want to thank all you guys that do officiate, and we have some pretty daggone good officials around here. I'm just, you know.
Right.
We really do.
And if you're thinking about it, go for it. It's, I think there's a shortage.
There is. I think there's a shortage. I think Coach Gorby can elaborate on that here in a little bit, but I think there's a shortage in all the sports.
Right.
I think exactly. It's baseball. I think it's everything. Volleyball. I'm sure they have a hard time getting track officials. I'm sure. I mean, it's all over the place.
There's a lot of people still in it because of the shortage. Like Coach Mike Whitley, I see him at cross country meets and track meets, still officiating. So, you know, sooner or later he's going to hang it up, and we need people in there to continue on the tradition of refereeing and officiating.
But
any and all sports.
That's right. But you know what? Two of the best officials are sitting right here. Girls' buddy league basketball. Yeah. You and I have done a few games together over
sure.
the years.
Yeah.
All right. Well, anyway, that was good to hear from Phil. Let's talk about us getting to go to the combo. Let's kind of change it up little bit. Let's talk about us getting to go up and do a game from the combo and the boys getting to play up there. Let's talk about that for just a second.
That was a dream for me. You know, that's where I went to college, was in Athens the last 3 years. First year I went down to the branch in Ironton, but that was really a dream for me to walk in that, because I knew what the venue was like. There's not a bad seat in the place, and I was just thinking, where are they going to put us? What are we going to do? You know,
well,
so it was
you
awesome.
Know, when we walked in, from the moment we walked in, tell the folks how good they treated
us.
Oh,
man.
They walked us up there. We said, well, how do we get there? Yeah. And the guy just finally looked and he said,
I'll
just take you.
Right.
And we did. And it was awesome.
And we got to enjoy the hospitality room.
That is true. That is true. But it was a big honor, I felt, for me that we got to do that game. We were the only student-led organization that got to do that game.
Right.
You know, you had everybody else there, but they were all paying to, you know, and they took care of our kids, too.
Yes.
Yeah, they really did. We appreciate that.
That's a first-rate organization up there as far as I'm concerned when it comes to that venue.
It was good. All right, let's talk about this. I didn't get to go to Zanesville to watch the regional games because it was, you know, 6 o'clock and there's no way I could get there. But anyway, you kind of tell us about going up to Zanesville. Tell us about the atmosphere and, you know.
It's a long trip. you have to take, you know, first you have to go to Athens, and then you take Route 13 out of Athens to Gloucester, Trimble, and through Crooksville, and then another 22 miles to Zanesville. But it was a nice gym, a really nice place, Zanesville High School. And it was, like I say, a tremendous defensive effort out of our ladies. And
they hold Sheridan, what was it, 31 points?
31 points. We beat them 58-31. And we held West Miss Kingdom to 27 and held, like I say, in the district final, Unioto to 22.
And I think, wasn't Bree matched up against the co-AP player
right.
of the year?
Right.
And Bree
really shut her down.
Just did a great job. So let's brag on her. Let's go ahead. Let's talk about going to Dayton in the Final Four with those girls.
Wow.
Just talk about that. Just talk about us, you know, going, getting to the venue.
It was, that's a nice place. I remember going, I couldn't remember that we went there 2 years in a row, though. For some reason, I thought we were at the Schottenstein Center, but that was an earlier group that Coach Buchanan took, and that was back in, 16 and 17?
I believe so.
And isn't it amazing that he has taken 4 teams out of the last, 7 years or 8 years, something like that? 7 years, I think.
I don't think there's too many programs around the state of Ohio that can, you know, even match that. Coach Gorby may know. I mean, he
knows he's on pace to be the all-time leading victories, Coach, ever at Fairland High School, boys or girls?
Well, again, let's talk about how he works that program.
Oh, my goodness. Year round. He was in the gym last night.
From the Buddy League girls all the way up through here. He's given his time all the time.
He starts in the summer. He has a summer league, or they call it the fall league. Then he has a winter league. And, of course, they have instructional days like Tuesday and Thursday. This week he's working with the middle school and some elementary. And I saw him in the gym last night. I said, you just can't stay out of the gym, can you? He said, no, we got to get better. We got to get better. And he makes them better. I mean, if anybody wanted to start a program, they need to come and talk to John Buchanan. But you've got to be able to put in the time. And he's got a good wife that's going to, as much as he's gone. And he puts in the time. He's got a great coaching staff. And, we talk about Adam Alt and Ronnie Canterbury, Les Wilson, and two ladies named Ashley Whitley Harris and... Ashley Harris-Whitley. Yeah, I better straighten that up.
And I still need to buy you that bottle of Focus Factor, don't I?
And her Prevagen. And Holly Harris-Donahue. So I just had to throw that Harris in there.
Of course you did. I would too.
Chip off the old blocks.
I know Coach Gorby and Jerry Bell and you and I got to do a pregame show up there in Dayton. Just tell them how good we were treated there, too.
As soon as we walked in, they checked and they found our names, said, oh, yeah, here. And they give us two different tags to wear, or with lariats around our neck, one for
media and one for
all-floor access. And we were able to go to the press conference afterwards. And it was
Coach Gorby told me, he said, look, I've done this before, but you've never got to be down there and experience this. And I just absolutely enjoyed the opportunity
to be there on the floor. We had great seats.
We did. And walking down that tunnel to get down to the floor.
I wish they had bigger cups for water, though.
Well, it's probably a good thing you'd had to go to the bathroom. So we're okay right there. But that was just a great experience for me. I really enjoyed that, and I appreciate the opportunity that we had to do that. So anything else about that trip?
As a coach, that's your dream. You know, you were a high school football coach, and it's just, you know, my dream came true when we made the playoffs in my first year as a head football coach. But the 20-plus years that I coached basketball, you know, I went to the boys state tournament 22 years in a row, and I'm sitting up there in the stand. But as a coach, your dream is to be there on that floor coaching, and John's got to do it four times.
Well, and we got to sit on the floor and watch him.
Yeah.
And that was awesome. I mean, it really was. And
we may not be done yet either.
That's right. We were the only group that did a pregame show up there.
Right.
You know, we weren't allowed to stream it for, broadcasting rights, but, we were the only other crew there that really got to do anything. And I appreciate the Ohio High School Athletic Association letting us come in and do that.
The media good, though, you know. I mean, all those seats and, we looked across the way and there's Tim Stevens and they just take care of you.
Yeah, it was a great time. It really was. All right, let's go on. We got to move on. We got a play of the game here. This is a clip of our very first basketball play of the game when Darius dunked against Gallia Academy. So here's a clip for you. So, Coach, what was your take on that? It was a pretty good one, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, anytime you get – I remember the first kid to ever dunk for – us when I was coaching was Jimmy Johnson, and then I had two others dunk, Ryan Scribner he could flat get up. He was a two-handed stuffer. And then in a scrimmage game, I watched Paul David Dillon just hammer a dunk. And I think he told me that was his cousin or somebody that he dunked on. But his was a tomahawk.
Well, Coach Gore and I were lucky to jump up and touch the bottom of the net. So
you're talking about getting a crowd up?
Oh
my. You have somebody dunk in a ball game.
Absolutely.
And the place goes berserk.
All right. So let's kind of change some stuff here. We want to talk about the Fairland Dragons network advancements and all the stuff. I'm going to go through here and give you a little bit of I'm going to read it for you folks. A little bit of history here. August 27th, 2020, our YouTube channel was created by the head of Fairland's IT department to provide the district the ability to stream some of the board's important board meetings for the community to watch. Now, you got to think about it. It was COVID time, Coach. Couldn't do anything, couldn't go anywhere.
Right.
So they came with the idea, well, let's start doing these board meetings and these other things. Well, so they started, broadcasting other things, but the channel's ownership was transferred to Jerry Bell back in August of 2022. And he kept the original name, IT Fairland. But our athletic director, Coach Gorby, came up with a vision. And he really did. He's been the visionary on all this stuff we're doing. We wouldn't be sitting here tonight doing this if it wasn't for Jeff Gorby. Okay? But what he wanted to do is he wanted to stream some of our sporting events. Now, I said some, okay, because it's a big thing to do. It really is. And Jerry Bell disagreed with the inconsistent brand of the image IT Fairland at the time. Well, he just didn't think that sounded good. So once class of 2024 arrived, what happened was we underwent serious reconstruction. I mean, everything changed. We came, a consistent brand image was added to our channel, but more importantly, we ditched the IT Fairland, and we transitioned to something better, which you guys are on now, which is the Fairland Dragons Network. Okay, and it's been awesome. Some of the new advancements, Coach, for this year include, listen to this, increased camera quality. Guys, we went out and bought new cameras. The graphics, you guys, look at these graphics you're looking at right here that you've got on your TV screen all around us. These are all generated. Higher quality of clip management. God, Coach, we had replays this year. We had all that.
We got so many great comments on, man, really enjoyed the replays.
It's just awesome. Double the amount of equipment. You and I have toted a lot of equipment around this year. And the big thing, though, is the amount of increased level of student involvement. I mean, these kids have done outstanding. I'm going to go ahead and just – I just want to brag on Braxton Trader for a minute. I mean, he just he's done so much. I mean, he worked on all this stuff today. Jerry Bell.
Jerry could go out and get him something to eat right now. He wouldn't worry.
That's right. Braxton could do it. I mean, that's true. And we're going to talk more about that. But let's talk a couple more things they want to manage. Fairland Dragons Network was fully permitted to broadcast football games held at either Jim Mayo Stadium or away stadiums. We didn't get to do Portsmouth West because there wasn't room for us. And we had the tape delay up at not this previous season, but Gallia Academy. But we're allowed to broadcast. And that's something for these guys at home, you guys at home, that couldn't make the game.
Right, and I appreciate the athletic directors from the visiting school.
Absolutely.
They wouldn't visit, but we were visiting them, like South Point, Chesapeake, Rock Hill.
Portsmouth. These places. They were good to us. Right. They really were.
Very accommodating.
Yes. However, this says the same policy here was not adapted for all the upcoming basketball season at the time. And we couldn't, Coach, there was just no way for us to do all those basketball games. There wasn't any way. We did access several away games for basketball, including, Coach, you got to think about it, we got to go to Southeastern when we played Uniodo, and we got to go again to Combo, and when we played Memphis, the boys played Memphis up there. And that was it's just awesome. It's awesome for these kids to be able to get to do this stuff. I mean, it's great. I do want to say one thing about us traveling. And to me, this was probably the most important thing, is the fellowship we had with the kids that traveled with us.
Yeah.
We had Zaid Mustafa was with us. you know, one time, and man, he just absolutely educated us.
Yeah, he blew me away.
On stuff, you know, he talked about stuff we didn't know. We took Braxton and Kate up with us to the convo, and we educated those guys.
Yeah.
Which, you know, on a lot of stuff. You know, they didn't know about the Silver Bridge collapse.
I
didn't
know any stupid jokes. You know, heck, I had to show them. There's more stupid jokes.
Well, and they got to see you singing. So that was a good thing. I mean, all four of us are going up the road singing. I mean, how often does that happen?
Well, that was a great song, you know.
Well, that's true, but good directions.
Good directions.
But we just, I mean, the fellowship we had with those kids and the good time we had, we got to break bread with them and eat dinner with them. And, by the way, appreciate that. You taking care of us that night. It was good. I want to recognize some of these kids from the Fairland Dragons Network. If I can just read them off here real quick. Braxton Trader, as I said, he has done so much. Alex Cyrus, Blaze Perry, Catherine Swalski, Cade Brewster, all kinds. Isabella Weinswag, Chloe Mick, Isabella Swindler, Jonathan Nida, Ryan Dixon's there a lot, Garrett Spence, defensive guru, did some stuff, Nolan Bennett, Ben Prino, Zaid Mustafa there was with us. And we had a middle schooler, Yardley Gorby.
Yeah, she had to carry her dad.
Well, somebody got to. Anyway, let's. I want to recognize all those. And you folks at home don't realize what these kids do. It is amazing. We're going to take a break here. We're going to throw it over to the AD, Jeff Gorby. He's got all kinds of stuff to talk to you guys about. So, Coach Gorby, you got it.
Again, we're going to talk a little bit about our viewership and where we've been over the last, last couple of years since we were able to take over here. Again, we couldn't do the stuff that we do without the support of our administrators, Ms. Ronnie Hayes, Ms. Tessa Leap. Those two ladies have been instrumental in what we've been able to do because they've kind of gave us the freedom of saying, hey, listen, as long as it doesn't cost a lot of money or more than $100, go do what you do and be good at it. So, again, August 26th of 2022 to March 26th, 2023, we had 56,000 views on our YouTube channel. So that was last year. We had 14,900 watched hours of film and 234 new subscribers. And then fast forward to this year, from August 26, 2023 to today, we've got 70,000 views. We're up 20,000 views this year alone. We've got 17,600 watched hours. So for 17,000 hours, people have been watching us and watching what we do. It's just amazing. We have 423 new subscribers. We're trying our best to get to 2,000. We've got about 1,970. Please, if you're not a subscriber to Fairland Dragon Network, please go subscribe. Our goal was 2,000 by the end of spring break. We want to get up to that number. Please do that. Over the lifetime of the Fairland Dragon Network and what started out as IT Fairland, we have 252,000 views. We have 59,000 watched hours, and we have 1.950 subscribers. Again, actually, that number is up to about 1970. We're about 30 away from 2,000. So if you're a sponsor and you want to have the opportunity to get your ad out there to people, again, this is a great opportunity and some things we're working on. I want to take this opportunity to thank some people because it's going to be my last time on the screen today. Coach Carroll, Coach Harris, I can't thank you enough. The original joke was you guys were the B team. You started out behind John Buchanan and Adam Ault. Those guys went to a basketball clinic, and I kind of scrambled, and I said, hey, let's put Coach Harris and Coach Carroll on there. And from then on, it has just been electrifying. Fireworks every night. You guys have made some outstanding play calls from Nelsonville, York playoff football game to the convo to a conference championships with the girls this year. Some outstanding calls, and again, I guess I can't thank you enough for that. Jerry Bell for allowing me and my harebrained ideas to come to life and being able to do this. I appreciate Jerry so much for that. I can't forget my brother-in-law, Josh, who does a lot for us. He's behind-the-scenes guy. He'll do some film work for us. He'll do some internet connection, anything we need, lugging things around. This year, Braxton Trader, thank you so much for everything. You have really brought this to the forefront for us and made our job a lot easier. My oldest daughter, Yardley, we were joking there earlier. During football season, we kind of made her a pack mule for us, running back and forth to our vehicles and getting stuff that we'd forgot. We worked her so hard down at South Point during the pregame show. We looked back, and she was laying on the track, sound asleep. She'd found a shady spot and a book bag, and she went to sleep. But again, then we put her on the camera during basketball season. Again, thank you so much, Yardley, for that. My wife for putting up with me and my craziness and allowing me to get to games extremely early so we could set up. And there's so many more that I need to thank. We want to talk about basketball awards. This past week, All-State awards had come out for all of our kids, girls and boys basketball. I'm going to list down, I'm going to start with each individual player and just list the awards that these individuals have won. Bree Allen, who'll be playing at Tiffin University with Fairland Dragon alumni Tommy Hinkle next year. She was the Southern Ohio Sports Authority Horizon Athlete of the Month, the Clark's Fruit and Vegetable Farm Athlete of the Week. She was the Hannah Ingemary Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight winner, first team all OVC, OVC Player of the Year, first team all District 13 Coaches Association, the District 13 Coaches Association Player of the Year, the Ohio Prep Sports Writers All District First Team, the Ohio Prep Sports Writers District Player of the Year. She was first team all Ohio, as voted on by the Ohio Sports Writer. She was academic all Ohio. She will be a representative for the Ohio team in the Ohio-Kentucky All-Star Game this year. She will be a representative this Friday night in the Ohio-West Virginia All-Star Game up in Parkersburg. She will also play in the Ohio North-South All-Star Game later on this month, and she's on a McDonald's All-American. Bree is probably graduating Fairland as one of the most decorated basketball players in school history. Congratulations on a great career, Bree. Next is Kylie Bruce going to Malone University. She was also the Clark's Fruit and Vegetable Athlete of the Week, the Hannah Ingemary Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight basketball player. She was honorable mention All-OVC, first team All-District 13, Ohio Prep Sports Writers All-District first team. She was third team All-Ohio. She was academic All-Ohio. She will also be playing in the Ohio-Kentucky All-Star Game, the Ohio-West Virginia All-Star Game, and she was a McDonald's All-American. Again, exciting career for Kylie. To see how far she came from her freshman year to now is just an amazing, amazing feat for her. Bailey Russell, who is a sophomore, she was a Clark's Fruit and Vegetable Farm Athlete of the Week. Hannah Ingemary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight Player. First team All-OVC. Second team All-District 13. Ohio Sports Writer, second team All-District. And she was honorable mention All-Ohio. Also in that class, sophomore Addison Godby. She's the Clark's Fruit and Vegetable Athlete of the Week. Hannah Ingemary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight Basketball Player. First team All-OVC. Second team All-District 13. She was the Ohio Sports Writer All-District second team, and she was honorable mention All-Ohio. Junior, Cam Barnetts. She was the Clark's Fruit and Vegetable Farm Athlete of the Week. Hannah Ingemary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight. First team All-OVC, special mention All-District 13, and Ohio Sports Writer All-District special mention. Our wrestlers this year, a couple wrestlers we had outstanding seasons. C.J. Graham, state runner-up, 126-pound. Is the best finish by a Fairland wrestler in school history. And Will Calicote, who was a state qualifier, he finished in the top 16 in the 190-pound class. We had the state powerlifting meet the same week the girls were in Dayton, up in Kenton. Our boys are four-time state champion as for the team. Individual state champions, Miss Emily Ferguson, Zoe Schmidt. This is her third straight powerlifting state championship. Congratulations to her on that. On the boys' side, Lucas Bompas, Dylan Collins, Will Calicote, Tristan Daly, and Austin Atkins were all state champions in their field. The cheerleaders finished, they were regional champions in August, and they finished fourth in the nation down in Walt Disney World in early February. Again, congratulations to them on a great season. Talk about our boys' basketball players. Chase Allen, Clark Fruit and Vegetable Athlete of the Week, Henning Airmary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight Player, first team All-OVC, first team
All-District 13, Ohio Sports Writer, All-District First Team, special mention All-Ohio that came out today. Brody Buchanan, who recently committed to play at the University of Rio Grande, who is a junior for us. He's a Clark Fruit and Vegetable Farm Athlete of the Week. Hannah Ingemary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight Player. He was the Southern Ohio Sports Authority Athlete of the Week earlier in the year. First team All-OVC, first team All-District. The Ohio Prep Sports Writer, All-District second team, and he was honorable mention All-Ohio. Will Davis, who is a senior who recently committed to play at Bethany. He's a Clark Fruit and Vegetable Farm Athlete of the Week. Hannah Ingemary, Bunch Realty Athlete Spotlight Player, first team All-OVC, honorable mention. Sorry, he was not first team All-OVC. He was honorable mention All-OVC, honorable mention All-District 13, and Ohio Prep Sports Writer All-District special mention. Leah Gorby also committed this week to play at Wilmington College. She's going to run cross country down at Wilmington. We got a few other kids that have several offers on the table. They're trying to make some decisions about that. Softball team off to a 2-1 start. Wins over Huntington St. Joe. Big win Saturday. Haley Sammons, walk-off, 2-run homer to win the first game for them. Baseball team is underway. Ethan Wall with a big home run last night. Kaylee Salyers for the softball team has 2 home runs. McKenna Black has 1 home run. Allie Shepard has 1 home run. Haley Sammons has a home run. Track gets underway this week at Ironton, the Ironton Classic. Been an exciting year as far as individual OVC champions, team OVC champions. We're just excited at what's going on here. Again, Codgers, I cannot thank you enough for everything you do. You're the backbone of this program. Thank you so much. Without me, it's just a – without you guys, sorry, without you guys, it's just a vision in my head of something that could be successful. You guys have made it what it is, and I appreciate you for that. We'll turn it back over to them, and they can talk about how some mascot media awards that we're up for this year, and they can tell you how that's going to go.
All right, Coach, it's time to vote. Everybody out there in Dragon Nation, it's time to vote. Our students and the Fairland Dragons Network crew have been nominated for National Awards, Coach. That's all over the United States, okay, for their work this past year. Now, this is a national competition, Coach. We are in the final round. You can go right there to mascotmedia.net to vote for our students and our team. Here are the categories that you can look at. Play of the Year, Event of the Year, Student Producer MVP, Best Teacher, and Best Student Run Broadcast Team. We can vote till April 5th, 2024 here. Please vote for us when you can. You can vote as many times as you want, Coach. Okay, you can go do it. Now, here's what I want you to understand. We are going against schools from Arkansas, Illinois, New Jersey, Connecticut, North Carolina, South Carolina. Some of these schools are 3 to 4 times our size. But we've made it to the national finals. Oh, so everybody out in Dragon Nation, we need you to go to mascotmedia.net and vote for our kids. Now, there is only one category that we didn't make it to, and that was the best professionally run broadcast team. Because we're not professionals. We are a student-run organization. Okay, we make no money. Our donations and our sponsorship money all go back into the Dragon's Eye Club for new equipment and help support our athletics. And that's what we do. So again, we've got Play of the Year, Event of the Year, Student Producer MVP, Best Teacher, and Best Student Run Broadcast Team. And we really, really, really would love to bring some awards back to this school, because I want you to think about how far this has come since Jerry Bell's taken over this and all the things that he's taught these kids. And honestly, it is amazing at the stuff that we're looking at.
Well, it's too bad they don't have an award for the oldest broadcaster.
Well, or the Codgers. I mean, and we got to thank Mary Johnson for getting our old Codgers shirts. We appreciate that.
Right, and we got to apologize to Hannah Nuggemeyer for Jeff Gorby butchering her name 15 times there.
Nah.
It's the first time I ever saw it. I thought, how do you pronounce that,
Hannah? I still can't say it. So.
Well, I have to open and close her pool, so she told me. She clued me in. It's Nuggemeyer.
Well, that's good. Let's kind of finish up here, Coach. We need to go back to football season. You and I are both old football coaches here, and
with the emphasis on old.
Well, this shirt I got on, I'm not gonna tell you how old it is, but it's seen a few washes in its day. But we couldn't wear green because we have the green screen behind us, so we had to wear white. So anyway, what we want to do here is we want to kind of recap the football season. Okay, now we got. We got some clips we want to do. It's pregame. First of all, we have a clip of Coach Chris Smith during a pregame show before the Dragons played Colgrove Hornets. And you and I have known Chris forever.
What's he now, the principal?
He's a principal at Colgrove now. Colgrove. But, he and I played football together in high school. I went to...
He coached with me. Outstanding individual.
I went to the Peach Bowl with him. He and I have been going to high school. We just all kinds of stuff. But anyway, if we can... we want to run that clip, Coach Smith.
Joined to my right with Coach Dave Carroll, and to his right, Coach Jack Harris. We got our guest on today, an old friend of ours, one of our assistant coaches. He was one of my coaches in school, Coker principal, Mr. Chris Smith. So I'm going to let these guys they got some questions for you, and talk a little bit about your adventure and how you got down here, Coach.
Well, Coach, I think first thing we need to talk about is look at the color he's got on. It's black. Can you imagine this guy in a black?
He looks good, and he'd look good in a burlap sack.
At least I hope you're watching now. We're giving him props. Chris and I have known each other 40-plus years, and he and I have traveled quite a bit together. We went to Peach Bowl last year, had a blast. This is one guy that I can be around, and we just laugh the whole time.
The whole time.
I mean, we have a blast. It's just, I sent him a thing, and sent him a text last night and asked him, I said, you ready? He said, nope. Lisa says FCC, you're only allowed to get on there. But anyway, Chris, just kind of tell us, you were at Fairland. I mean, you've been up there. You substituted. You were a teacher there. You were a coach there. You went to Chesapeake. You were the just kind of tell us how this come about.
Well, when you called me last night and we were talking, I didn't realize until I started thinking about it. This is my first year there. It was 1990. That's been 33 years ago. And, back then we were all the young pups. Mm-hmm. Now you turn around, it's like, where'd the time go? Because now we're the old guys at the end of our careers. And, Jeff was playing. Coach Jackson was our quarterback, middle linebacker at the time. You and I were coaching junior high football. And then, Coach Snyder and Coach Whitley, those guys gave me a chance to coach. And then Coach Harris gave me the ultimate opportunity I was looking for. That was to be paid to be a high school assistant coach. Mm-hmm. And he took a chance on me, when, quite frankly, no one else would. And
daddy would have whooped my butt.
I learned so much from you.
That's Joe Smith's son right here, one of the greats at Chesapeake, and it just handed it right on down to the boy.
Well, I appreciate that, but I'm telling you, I had more fun up there with you guys, and those are lifelong friendships, with you all, and then Jeff and I still working together through the OVC, and Brian Ward. I can't thank you guys enough for the opportunity you guys gave me 30 years ago.
Well, we thank you for helping us out, brother.
Coach, probably the most lasting thing, I mean, life lessons, and you and I get to still work together from time to time with the OVC, but probably my all-time favorite is taking you up to Locks 27 after a ball game. You promise us if we win, you were going to jump in the river. Now, it was you probably thought it was -8 that night, but it was extremely cold. But I remember you tying that rope on your waist and jumping right in the river there. And that's a lifelong memory I have. And all of us, it was there that night.
What'd they do? Let go of the rope?
No, you told me before I jumped, you said, please don't drown. Because you said you'd end up getting fired. But, Coach Davis, and I had worked for him too, and just a fantastic guy down in Chesapeake. And, he had said he would jump in the river, so we were just looking for something to give give us just a little bit of motivation. And, like an idiot, I said I'd do it. And, so we win, and I ended up doing it.
Memories.
Yeah.
Yes.
Kind of tell us, you were principal down there, but I know last year that you did some other things down there at Chesapeake. Can you give us kind of an idea of what you did down there?
Yeah, I did every job imaginable down there. I was a teacher, coach, assistant principal, athletic director, principal. And then I went over to the board office, and I was doing buildings and grounds and food service, that type of thing. And it was fine. And Mr. Hale gave me a great opportunity to do that, and I thank him, too. But that just wasn't me.
He's a good, great guy.
Yeah.
Doug Hale.
Uh,
Well, you better take some credit here because you're the guy that helped get that turf, that new turf down there in Chesapeake this past year.
Well,
so.
Yeah, we put that in, and, you know, that was one of the last things we did down there. I was really proud of that, and it looks fantastic, and, you know, yeah, as long as it's for the kids.
We'll be down there next week.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Sure will. So, you know, I didn't feel like I was doing, you know, what I was called to do, and this opportunity arose, and I jumped on it, and I've had a great time down here. The people at Coal Grove have treated me fantastic. Made a lot of new friends already. Co-workers are great, and I really enjoy being here.
Coach, you know, we appreciate you coming on. A lot of memories. I told my wife this morning, I said I'm more excited about this game day show tonight just for the opportunity to have you on here. Like I said, lifelong friends to me. My junior high coach, my high school coach, he kind of followed me up, and one of my mentors. I appreciate everything, Coach. Thank you so much, and I know – Coal Grove is extremely lucky to have a guy like you down here.
Well, thank you. And you guys at Fairlands the same way, with all you guys still involved. And again, I can't thank you guys enough. And thank you guys for having me. I really appreciate it. Love you, Coach.
I love you too, man. It's good to see you.
You too.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
We'll let you get back.
If that don't bring a smile to your face, I don't know what does.
I
mean,
he's just, you know, he's so positive. I've never seen him really get mad or irate about anything. He's
well, when you do, you're going to see his face get red and that vein in his forehead pop out. That's what you're going to see. I can tell on him about that. he and I've got so many stories, just traveling around, just enjoying each other's company, and you know, that's a lifelong friend right there. Like Coach Gorby, you know, he even said it right there. It's you know, it's connection that you make with people, and the friendships and the camaraderie. You know, he and I don't get to do a whole lot of stuff together anymore, but by God, we do.
He probably knows more people than you now.
Oh, I'm sure he does.
Being a Fairland, then Chesapeake.
I don't know too many.
Oh, yes, you do. You know people I've never heard of.
Anyway, that coach, for me, that's one of my favorite clips of the pregame shows that we had because he means so much to me. And
yeah, he treated us well down there.
He will. He's always successful, whatever he does.
He was a fine assistant coach as well.
Anyway, folks at home, I guess y'all noticed the sponsorships popping up in that right-hand corner that we had going there. And I just want to throw this out there. If you guys are interested in sponsoring next year, get a hold of Coach Gorby because he's got packages he's going to do next year. I don't know a whole lot about that. I'm not privy to that. But anyway, he's going to be doing some sponsorship packages. If you guys would like to support the Dragons and support the kids here at the Fairland Dragons Network and everything we do, get a hold of him, 886-3250, and tell him you'd like to sponsor, because we'd love it. I mean, I don't know what all he's doing, but guys, all this equipment we have is because of you, the sponsors.
Yeah, it costs money.
It costs a lot of money. All right, so next clip we got is Coach Michael Jackson, who's also down at Coal Grove, and we're going to let that go, and then when we get off that clip, I'm going to let you talk about Michael. Because Michael's awful special to you. So
yes, he is.
Here we go, guys. Get this next clip.
Yeah. For 10 yards, and Jack Hayden caught three for 30.
And CJ had one called back. I think he had a 23 yarder called back.
Yeah, it was a nice one.
Yes.
Coach Jackson, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I know that you watch a lot of film this week from this year and the last 30 years to see the same thing that you're probably going to see tonight.
Yep.
Murphy kid, pretty good running back. Disciplined team, want to run 6-7 hole. Tell us what else you've seen on film this week.
You know, they actually throw the ball off boot more than Jay has in the past. Mm-hmm. So, but still all play action.
They have that quarterback counter.
Yeah, still the quarterback counter back, and they still do that one false pull every now and then.
Yeah, you know. Sucker play, huh?
Yeah, but you know, they got a big strong line. They'll go foot to foot and just try to outman us down the field and try to keep the ball away from us. I'm sure.
They're definitely going to try to lull you to sleep a little bit and hit that one little bootleg pass. So, Coach, you know, had a pretty successful season so far. We talked a lot about Peyton. You know, you've had a great, great season. You've been very transparent with us over the 8 weeks now, letting us come in and be a part of your program. What do you think right now, if I had to ask you right now, what do you think is probably one of the biggest accomplishments that you've had as a team right now?
As a team.
We'll put you on the spot.
Yeah. the getting our mentality back after the Ironton loss, probably. Because I felt like we had it early in the season anyways, and after that bad loss, you know, it's easy to lose a team, you know, lose your locker room after that, and we didn't. We stubbed our toe that game, you know, but, you know, don't let, like, one play make a second bad play.
Right.
Don't make one bad game make a
– next play.
Next
play.
So that's probably one of my proudest things of them is just putting that behind them and continuing on, what, 5 straight since then, so –
And I agree. You're probably 100% correct. Just going back to the drawing board, getting back to it, and win. And a couple weeks later, winning a huge game against a guy.
Oh yeah, I mean that's, you know, guys is a division bigger, and they was undefeated when we played them, and you know they might lose or not against Ironton, but at the worst they're going to be an 8-2 team, you know, and P West probably is going to be at worst an 8-2 team. So to have them two wins on your resume going into playoffs, that's pretty good. That's why we're up there,
right,
kind of high in the standings.
So, well, senior night, you know, it's senior night here. What's the message we're going to hear before you know that you're going to come out emotionally high for this game because of senior night? You know, what's the message we're telling our kids?
Well, you know, we always hope you have a motivation every week. You know,
right,
you want to be self-motivated anyways, but you got something this week, you know. Last week we had two things, you know. We clinched the playoffs with a win, and we become the winnings in class and school history. So that was two big things to motivate. Tonight, we win tonight, we 100% clinch a first-round home playoff game for the first game, you know what I mean? So that's our motivation this week. And talk about motivation, every Thursday, you know, we have Feed the Team. And different people from different walks of life come in, talk on Thursdays, you know, speak to us, usually for like 15 minutes or so. You know, we might have a preacher, a teacher. We had Mr. Allen, you know, talk one night, and people in the community, we had Zach Tooley one night, just different walks of life to try to tell them kids about different aspects of life, you know, just something to get them. But last night, we was blessed with a guy named Brandon McGuire, and 2 weeks ago, I met him by chance at Texas Roadhouse. Me and Kelly always go. I pick Kelly up after work on Fridays. That's our routine on game day. We go to Texas Roadhouse, have an appetizer, just the thing we do, you know. And 2 weeks ago, I met this guy and talking to him, and then found out he was retired out of the military, and he actually was a sniper in Iraq and Afghanistan. And he said, look me up, you know, and if you want. So me and Kelly go YouTube him. He's on History Channel, was one like 10 deadliest measure. He shot a guy at 1,300 meters, you know what I mean? That's unreal accomplishment, right? 1,300 meters, it's almost a mile.
Yeah.
And so, of course, you know, I said, man, we'd be honored to have you come.
Oh, yeah.
And he jumped right on. He's originally from Kansas and joined the military, and he got stationed at Marshall over the ROTC his last few years of the military. And just having him speak to our kids last night, telling him about, I mean, you talking about American hero, man. He, paratrooper, was in Afghanistan, was in Iraq, was in firefights in Afghanistan, was laid up. Watch that sometime. Look up, just YouTube Brandon McGuire, and you know, he holed up for 3 days inside this building, and what the message he gave our guys was about accountability. You know, he's like, we don't care who the president is, what the politics is. He said, you end up fighting for the guy beside of you. Mm. Just like football, you know. No matter what your coach says, you're playing for your buddy beside of you. So.
Coach, there's no other sport, as far as I'm concerned, that prepares a young man for the game of life like football.
And that's one of the things he mentioned, you know. He was a football player in high school, and he said his tour days prepared him for boot camp.
Right. Yep.
You know, and just, we, you know, use our speakers for 15 minutes. I told him, I said, you've earned the right to talk as long as you want. You know, you talk about whatever you want. And he was there for 45 minutes because we kept asking questions, you know. And you know, some of them guys have seen that and been part of that. You know, they can't talk about it. And that's understandable, you know.
Right.
But he was up front, and it was just a great experience for our kids, I think, to see a true American hero in my books, you know what I mean?
Yep.
It was great for him last night.
That's good. And I'm glad that you had the opportunity to bring him in. That's great for our kids and great for our community. Coach, good luck to you. 3 hours, we're going to be out here. We'll shake hands in the winner's circle.
Be 8-1, right?
That's right.
Let's get it.
That's right.
Hey, appreciate you guys. Keep it going. I'll see you upstairs.
Good luck, sir. Brother.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate you. You know, big.
All right, Coach. I want you to talk about Michael. This is your baby here. I love Michael, but this is your guy, and I want you to talk about him.
Well, just watching that clip, just, you know, his love and passion for the game of football and his team. You know, it's got to strike you right there in the heart. And he was my first quarterback, and, you know, we sort of changed things around a little bit.
Wait a minute. Before we go there, let's talk. Tell about these folks at home. No, you didn't change things a bit. You reshaped the football in the tri-state area because you went from running the wing T and the power I, and you went out with three receivers one side and another one on the left. There was nobody that did that around here. You revolutionized the game around this tri-state area.
Well, it was something that I thought that this group of athletes could perform and execute, and he was one of the main reasons. You know, I watched him throw the football, and I thought, you know, we had receivers that could catch it. You know, we had T.J. Henson and Willie Mills and Mark Hinkle, J.D. Smith, Damian Southard. All those guys were great athletes, and we had a good line, too. You know, Jeff Gorby was our center, and he never had a bad snap out of the shotgun the entire year or any other way. And again, you know, you talk about guys buying into what you want to do. Well, they did 100%, and we were able to go 9-1 and make it to the state playoffs for the first time in school history, which is something I'm very proud of, really a highlight of my football coaching career. And Michael,
you know, was your middle linebacker.
That's why I was just getting ready.
And playing quarterback.
Quarterback and middle linebacker. You don't see that often.
You don't see it hardly ever.
Right.
Most of the time, he was just that tough. Quarterback didn't play defense.
Right.
You know, I had a chance short. He didn't want to touch defense. He just wanted to play quarterback. He didn't want to play defense.
What you noticed is some Peyton wanted to play defense, and they wouldn't let him. Yep. But they put him in there a few times there at the end. But Michael was always going to be special to me, and I wish him nothing but the best. And to watch his son, you know, we got some more clips, but this one you won't see. But to watch his son Peyton, with 4 seconds to go in the game and down 3, against Portsmouth West in the first hit football game for him as a head coach, and his son ran it in from about 12 yards out.
With how many seconds left?
Four seconds.
And that's the one game we didn't get to broadcast, Coach.
Right. And he scored that game-winning touchdown. That I was so happy for his son, but I was more happy for Michael. It was his first football game. And I said, you know, I was just so happy for him. I was so excited. And you and I were able to sit right there in the end zone and watch him cross that goal line.
But, well, who got that block? Who was it got that block that sprung him into the end zone? I can't remember who. Was it Christian Collins?
I think it was a wide receiver.
He just annihilated some kid. Or
Keegan. He was one of those two. But
he walked into the end zone.
Yeah. Well.
From about 15 yards out.
It was awesome. And what a great way to start your career as a head football coach. And I know that's special to him. And just like it was special to me. We beat Portsmouth West for the very first time, my first game, and we won the game 18-0. And we were ahead 12-0, and there wasn't a whole lot of time left, and we were down close to the end zone, and we're getting ready to score again. And I called, you know, we're going to get in a power or a full house, and I called Power 6 bootleg run. And Michael practically walked into the end zone, and that kind of capped it for us at 18-0. And I'm thinking, you know, he scored. It wasn't the winning touchdown, but it was the get it out of reach touchdown. Right. And then to see Peyton do that for him. It's just special. Those things are special to me. And I just, you know, I love the guy and hard-nosed, and he's going to do. And I told him, I said, I've got one bit of advice for you. You know, I did it my way. And and it worked out for us. And I told him, I said, Michael, do it your way. And he had a vision, and I watched those guys, and I'm thinking, gosh, how's he getting the plays in, you know? It was...
Well, you and I are used to grabbing a kid and sending them in with the play.
Right.
Times have changed, Coach.
Yes, they have.
We are old codgers.
Yeah.
Dinosaurs.
But it's a special thing, and I was really happy for him. I said, man, you know you're going to go at least 9-1. You know, you got to go 9-1, make the playoffs, and that's exactly what he did. But big game against Gallia. Of course, like he said, stubbed her toe against Ironton, but a lot of people do that.
Well, we didn't play very well, but let's give Ironton credit. They're a pretty daggone good
football team. Fantastic football team, football program.
Absolutely.
But he's going to do well, and I wish him nothing but the best.
Well, I'm proud of him, too, and I'm very proud of him. You know, his wife, Kelly, works down here in the kitchen, takes good care of me every day, and so shout out to her. And we better move on, Coach. We're behind time. All right, next thing we're going to do, we got a picture. Jason Morris, we're going to pop up here for you folks to see. And I want to brag on Jason because Jason, we didn't have a public address announcement.
Right, stepped right in there.
And we got a hold of Jason and said, Jason, can you come over? And he's like, well, you know how he is. And, of course, he did. Volunteered
to come
took
job,
over. And you know what? If I have an issue with a vehicle, I go see Jason Morris. So I just drop a call and send him a text. Hey, man, here it is. Fix it. Do it. And you know what? The guy treats you right. He's honest. And, I mean, what else can you say?
He's a good preacher, too.
Yeah, that is true. He is. He's a great man. And, Jason, we appreciate you. All right, our next picture is Linda Bird receiving a new camera during the pregame show.
Before well, she playoff was surprised, game. Wasn't she?
Yeah, I wasn't there. I was on the road
night. That's right.
So I wasn't there. But anyway, you guys got to present her with that brand new camera. That's awesome because she takes so many pictures of our kids here. And we have so many people
there's
here
a
that
sporting
are.
Sporting event, you're going to see her.
That's
there.
Right. And they're so good to our kids. You know, they post pictures. Just amazing. You know, we have to appreciate all those people. All right. So we appreciate them, those two. We want to get them here. All right, the next thing we're going to do, Coach, is Keegan's interception during the game against Gallia Academy. And this is a clip. As a matter of fact, this is the clip that we have sent as one of our things to win an award. And you had the call right there. So, guys, we can run that clip. We'll see this one-handed interception by Keegan.
Twin receiver stacked. Rathbun drops. He's looking. He's throwing deep. And it's intercepted by Keegan Smith. Out.
Was left hand, too.
Well, I here's the thing about that. They were driving.
They
could have tied the game or gone ahead on that play. And Keegan kind of baited that guy, and the guy threw the ball, and he made a super play out there with that left hand and brought it in. I mean, that was awesome. So that's one of the clips. The next clip we got, Bryson Hunt. He made a catch inside the end zone with toe. I mean, I don't know if we have a steal of it.
Double toe touch.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I remember this.
So, folks, watch this clip right here. You're going to love it. It's down against Colgrove.
Maybe it was another face mask. Jackson rolling out. He's going to throw it in the back of the end zone. And...
Sweet. And, Coach, here's the thing. We don't have the steal, but the guy from the newspaper, I believe it was the Herald Dispatch, I believe is who had it. There is a picture of him right there, and his toes are right there. Just it's perfect. It was a perfect pass. It was a perfect catch. Right. Had to be that had to be perfect for that play to work, and that was great. Okay, we got another one here. This is the one that you really like. And, Coach, we had a lot of clips we could have picked from.
Sure.
But you know, here's one. This is
Cameron Kitts.
Cam Kitts a touchdown against, I believe it was Rock Hill, but Bryson Hunt, two pancake blocks to help get him.
Was
it
a kickoff return?
It was a kickoff return.
Yeah.
So, Coach, we're going to see that one right now. Here we go.
Hey, look out. Look out. He did this last time. Great block there by Bryson Hunt. Another great block. He knocked two guys down.
So you had the call on that right there, and tell us about that. Wasn't that just, that was just awesome, wasn't it?
You know, Cam had returned one the week before. I've never seen anybody take kickoffs back two consecutive weeks in a row opening kickoff. I believe it was. You've seen a lot of daylight there.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
pretty sure it was the opening kickoff. And I just happened to watch. That guy had the angle on Cam, and, of course, Bryson eliminated that angle real quick. And there was another kid coming. I thought, well, he stayed on his feet, and he pancaked that kid, too. I just thought that was tremendous effort.
Oh.
You know, those things you really don't coach. You coach them how to hit them, but you don't coach effort.
But as
effort's
a coach,
got to come from right
that's
here.
The kind of play that you want to see.
Yes.
And that's the kind of kid right there, it's an MVP that's going to go above and beyond. Yeah, he could have stopped after blocking that first guy, but Bryson
sure.
said, nope, I'm going to get him. And that sprung him into the end zone.
Okay.
So that was awesome. The next thing I want to show you guys is I want to talk to you about our kicker, Aiden Miller. Okay. And if we can pop him up on the screen, I want to show you about what happened with him. He went to the Ray Guy kicking camp. And he's, of course, 2005. You saw Aiden right there. But I want you to look. We put some stats up there for you, what he did. You know, look at the distance of the different things that he did right there. This kid, if he improves at all, is going to be a college kicker. He has the potential. I mean, he's got, you know, he was talking about hang time and how he's, you know, couple tenths of, you know, being right there at the college. You can see his, what his accuracy was. You can see some distance that he did on kickoffs.
What grade is he in?
He's a junior, I believe,
junior.
Isn't he?
I believe he is.
I think so.
Well, I'm going to tell you what, he had a few kicks there late in the season.
He got in the end zone.
NFL kicks.
Oh, yeah.
Halfway
I mean,
in the end zone.
He did a great job. And I want to, you know, I want to give him some props because I did a little bit of kicking, not much, but a little bit of kicking in high school.
He was outstanding from after the first game, just outstanding.
I'm proud of him. And like I said, that's a Ray Guy camp, and we all know.
And an integral part of a football team.
Absolutely.
You know?
Well, you got to have special teams if you're going to be successful. Right. There's no doubt about that. What I want to do now, Coach, is there any other memorable things you want to talk about football season? I mean, there are so many things with this team that we watched this year. I mean,
yeah, you know, I know one kid we haven't mentioned his name yet, but I remember watching him just absolutely run through, over, and into the end zone. Mr. Quentin Cremeen
was down at South Point. We almost brought that.
It was like a Quentin Cremeen's highlight reel that entire drive.
Well, we also had some defensive players. Think about Ryan Dixon.
Oh, Dixon.
Think about Garrett Spence.
Yes.
You think about all the different – and think about the interceptions our kids had this year.
Yeah, Will Calico had a big one against Portsmouth in the first game.
Well, we had guys in the secondary that just
– Well, a lot of skill athletes.
Oh, absolutely. And there's so many things that we can say, but
– And the line, you know, we don't give the line enough credit, but they were outstanding.
Yeah, they were. They were. All right. Let's do this. I want us to go through some thanks and some shout-outs, and then we've got a little montage of pictures we're gonna do here at the end, kind of close it out. But I want to talk about, first of all the sponsors that sponsored us this year. I'm not going to go through and name them, but we appreciate you guys taking care of us.
Sure.
We appreciate all the people that donated food to feed us old guys. We had some good meals in football. And even
Ronnie Watch comes to mind.
Hey, I mean, just.
All you had to do was mention that. Well, then we don't have any food, and there'd be a pizza there.
I mean, people just took really good care. I mean, just absolutely took good care of us everywhere we went. We need to thank Doug Morris from Armstrong.
Absolutely.
That guy has been with us since day one. We started out with a microphone, a set of two sets of headphones, and a camera. And look where we're at right now.
I know.
And, you know, Doug, thank you. We got to thank Josh Ross, Coach Jeff Gorby, for his vision to do this. We got to thank Braxton Trader, all the kids from the FDN Network, the Dragon's Eye Club. I mean, all this stuff that, you know.
That old fella sitting over there.
I was leaving him for last. But Jerry Bell has just blown us up.
Yep.
And all this stuff you see here around us, and it's amazing.
They
and
don't see what we see. All they see is
that's
this right here.
They don't know all the work.
They have no idea what this guy does. And whenever there's a glitch, I'm just sitting there going, well, Jerry will get it figured out in a minute, or Doug will get it figured out. One of those two guys will get it figured out.
We're sitting in Dayton, and the internet goes out. And right. Jerry's like, psh. Well, we're sitting in the convo, and the convo switcher went out. Jerry just said, plug it into ours. I mean, he figured it out, got it working. You know, what can you say? I mean, there's not a whole lot you can say about there. Just, and so many people, like I said, I wrote some things down here. So many people to thank. You know, my sister and brother-in-law, Mary and Tom Johnson, I mean, like I said, giving us a shirt, but they're always, you know, putting us out on social media. They're always, you know, they bought us those Codgers shirts. I mean, just all that kind of stuff, you know.
I just want to thank everybody that made a comment. It seemed like after every game or during a game.
Yep.
We appreciate you guys. You guys are doing a great job. We love the Codgers. And I mean, it just went on and on and on. And I'm thinking, gee, Manny, no negativity from anyone.
No.
Just it just warmed your heart and made you feel like you was doing a decent job.
That's right. I want to also thank my kids, Isabel Brim and Nick and his wife down in Georgia. He's currently active in the military.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to thank all of our active military people. I want to thank all of our veterans.
Yes.
If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be sitting here today doing this.
You know, they talk about heroes and stuff. Military is a true American hero.
My son is a hero. He's serving. And he's doing something I never did.
Just unbelievable.
Appreciate that.
Okay, I better give my shout out.
You better.
I'm going to get in trouble. My wife, Peggy, and my daughters, Ashley and Holly, along with their husbands, Matt and Keith, my grandchildren, starting from the oldest to the youngest, Stella Grace, Lola Jean, Cash Harris Whitley, Rosie Jacks Donahue, and little Miss Frankie Jean Donahue.
Well, there's one more person I want to thank before we do our little montage, and that's you.
Oh, man.
Love you.
I have never had so much fun in my life. I never thought that, you know, when they said that me and you were going to sit in for John and Adam, I thought, wow, man, this is going to be fun. And then they had us come back.
I know. But, you know, the thing with me is
I hope to have us come back next
year. I hope they do. The relationship you and I have had over the last 4 years, if you'd have told me 20 years ago the Jack Harris that I knew back then that you and I'd be sitting here doing this, I'd have said, nope. But here we are. And I just want you to know I appreciate you.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. I appreciate working with you. But I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I don't care who that offends, but that's the way I feel.
Well, I feel the same way.
Great.
All right, guys, we're going to get choked up. But what we want you to do is we've got a montage of some pictures. We're going to play that for you. I don't know how long. Jerry, how long is that?
5 minutes.
It's about 5 minutes. There's a little bit of music to it. We want you to enjoy. These are pictures of us. I mean, there's some from 4 years ago. There's some from this year. There's a lot of pictures of kids that we've tried to put in. There's a lot of pictures of me and you, the crew. So you guys enjoy the next 5 minutes, and then we'll come back and we'll sign off.
You are able, woman, I am willing to make the break that we are.
What did you think about that, Coach?
I love the music. But, yeah, a lot of memories right there. You know, I'm sitting there thinking, well, that was South Point. That was Cold Grove. That was Iron. You know.
Well, many pictures did I have from the COVID years there?
A couple.
Yeah.
I remember that I could not announce wearing a mask, so I kind of cheated.
No, you would never do that.
Well, you know, they were saying you didn't wear your mask because you're going to get thrown out.
Well, you know, Braxton and Jerry and them put that together for us today.
That was awesome.
They asked me what kind of music, and you know what? You know why I picked that song? Because we got to keep on rolling.
Yeah.
You know, we've got to keep on rolling. We want to do this next year. And, guys, we want to make it better. We want you guys at home to have a better experience than what you had this year. And hopefully, Coach, you and I will be a part of that.
I hope so.
That's what we're wishing.
Good Lord willing.
That's right.
The creek don't rise.
Jerry Bell, Braxton Trader, Coach Gorby, thank everybody for, you know, pulling this together. Thank you guys for tuning in. I told Jerry Bell, I said, we'll do this in maybe a half hour. Where are we at, Jerry?
About an hour and 45.
Hour and 45 minutes. So, anyway.
A lot to talk about when you're talking about a lot of sports, and we covered them all, I think.
Anything you want to finish out?
I just want to thank everybody for your kindness and for your viewership, and that hope we can. And I don't see why we won't go again and how it can get better. I don't know, but these guys will figure it out.
These guys will do it. I feel so fortunate and so blessed to be here to be able to do this, especially with you. And we want to thank you guys out there for making this possible for us. Because without you guys watching this, it wouldn't be anything.
Right.
And it's kind of humbling.
It's just remarkable. I mean, they have no idea what a kick you and I get out of this. And
I put some pictures of us, you and I going on road trips and, you know, like I said, you know, I put a picture in there of, you know, you and I and Braxton and Cade sitting there eating.
Right.
You know, Coach, that was making memories. That was a good time. That's what all this is about.
Right.
And
I hope you have enjoyed this show. I know I've enjoyed watching these guys bring it to you and being a part of it. And, brother, you don't know how much I appreciate you. And it's like you said, you know, I never thought that you and I would be doing this. And all I can say is from the old Codgers, we love you guys.
Yeah, we do. We love you. Coach, I love you. And
likewise.
Hey, appreciate it. You guys tune in. Keep looking on FDN Network on YouTube. You know, who knows? Maybe one of us will show up at a softball or baseball game. You never know. But we're planning on next fall for sure. Yep. That's our plan. So thank you for tuning in this evening or whenever you're watching. Thank you so much. If you want to sponsor anything, just get a hold of Jeff Gorbury, 886-3250. Again, we appreciate you guys for watching. Thank you so much. We love you, Dragon Nation.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.